we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section Ordinary Differential Equations. This problem has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020, and it is from the section C. The problem is, let f of x comma y is equal to, it's given as an ordered pair whose first component is y plus x multiplied by in brackets 1 minus x square minus y square bracket close comma the second component minus x plus y into in brackets 1 minus x square minus y square bracket close and the ordered pair bracket close, and consider the ordinary differential equation which is given as ordered pair x dot comma y dot is equal to f of x comma y with initial condition ordered pair x at 0 comma y at 0 is equal to the ordered pair 0 comma 1 by 2. Which of the following statements are true? Options. Option 1, x square of t plus y square of t tends to infinity as t tends to infinity. Option 2, x square of t plus y square of t tends to 0 as t tends to infinity. Option 3, x square of t plus y square of t remains bounded as t tends to infinity. Option 4, x square of t plus y square of t tends to 1 as tends to infinity. Let's now discuss the solution of this problem in detail. We are given f of x comma y as an ordered pair like this, whose first component is this, the second component is this one, and x dot y dot, an ordered pair, is given as f of x comma y. This is the ordinary differential equation. With initial conditions, the ordered pair x at 0 comma y at 0 is equal to the ordered pair 0 comma 1 by 2. This implies x dot y dot is equal to f of x comma y, but f of x comma y is given to be an ordered pair like this, and that is written here. Now x dot y dot, the ordered pair, is equal to the ordered pair here. So these two are equal if and only if the first component is equal to first component, the second component is equal to the second component. So x dot is equal to this one. This implies x dot is equal to y plus x into 1 minus x square minus y square. And the second component, y dot, is equal to the second component here, minus x plus y into 1 minus x square minus y square. And what do we mean by x dot? It is dx by dt. So dx by dt is equal to y plus x times 1 minus x square minus y square. Dy by dt is equal to, that is y dot, the above one is written. The initial condition, x at 0 is 0, y at 0 is 1 by 2. So now, what we do is, there is this x square plus y square is appearing here. So we will multiply the first equation by x and the second equation by y, and we add. So you will get x dx by dt plus y dy by dt is equal to xy plus x square into 1 minus x square minus y square plus y into minus x, that is minus yx into plus y into y square into 1 minus x square minus y square from here. So these are added, xy minus xy cancels, and you will get x square plus y square as a common factor. The common factor is 1 minus x square minus y square, and that multiplied by x square plus y square. Now what we see is x square plus y square and x dx by dt plus y dy by dt is appearing here. Put now this we have written multiplied throughout by 2. So 2x dx by dt plus 2y dy by dt is equal to 2 times x square plus y square into 1 minus x square minus y square. So put x square plus y square is equal to t, is equal to u, sorry. So x square plus y square is equal to u. Differentiating, then we will get 2x dx by dt. Differentiating with respect to t, we will get 2x dx by dt plus 2y dy by dt is equal to du by dt. Then the above equation becomes du by dt is equal to 2 into u into 1 minus u. Now the variables are separated. 1 by u into 1 minus u du is equal to 2 dt. We got the differential equation and variables are separated. We continue. We have already separated the variables and now integrating on both sides. So integral of 1 by u into 1 minus u du is equal to 2 integral dt plus a constant ln c. But this is written as the partial fractions. Integral of 1 by u plus 1 by 1 minus u du is equal to 2 times integral of dt plus ln c, where c is the constant of integration. Integrating, we will get ln u, logarithm to the base e, u, ln u minus, the integral is ln of 1 minus u and a minus ln of 1 minus u, 2t plus ln c. And log a minus log b is equal to log of a by b, ln of u by 1 minus u is equal to log a plus log b is equal to log a b, log c e power 2t. Then you will get u by 1 minus u is equal to c into e power 2t. So this is the solution of that differential equation. Now in this, to evaluate c, put t is equal to 0. Then you will get u at 0 by 1 minus u at 0 is equal to c. But what is u at 0? U at 0 is x square at 0 plus y square at 0. Because u is x square plus y square, u of t is equal to x square t plus y square t. When t is equal to 0, u of 0 is equal to x square 0, x square at 0 plus y square at 0. And we have that initial conditions, x at 0 is 0, y at 0 is 1 by 2. So this is equal to 0 plus 1 by 2 whole square is equal to 1 by 4. Now we go back and substitute in this. U at 0 is 1 by 4 by 1 minus u at 0 is minus 1 by 4 is equal to c. And the numerator is 1 by 4, the denominator is 3 by 4. And then cancelling 4, both in the numerator and denominator, we get c is equal to 1 by 3. Therefore, the solution is u by 1 minus u is equal to c is 1 by 3 e power 2t. Cross multiply, we will get 3u is equal to e power 2t into 1 minus e power 2t into u. Brought forward, it is here. So we want to solve for u. This implies u of 3 plus e power 2t, bringing this to the left hand side, you will get e power 2t, and u is equal to u power 2t by 3 plus e power 2t. What is u? X square plus y square. So writing as a function of t, u is x square at t plus y square at t is equal to this one. Now divide both numerator and denominator by e power 2t, then you will get 1 by 3 e power minus 2t plus 1. So you will get x square of t plus y square of t, that is u, is equal to 1 by 3 e power minus 2t plus 1. Now As t tends to infinity, what happens to this? As t tends to infinity, e power minus 2t tends to 0, and this will tend to 1. So this will tell you x square at t plus y square at t tends to 1, converges to, tends to 1 as t tends to infinity. As t tends to infinity. And as t tends to infinity, x square t plus y square t is bounded. So further, x square t plus y square t remains bounded as t tends to infinity. So these are the two conclusions that we are drawing from the question. Let's look at the options. In these options, the first one, x square t plus y square t tends to 1 as t tends to infinity, appears against option 4. Therefore, the option 4 is true. And the second one, the second further result is x square t plus y square t remains bounded as t tends to infinity. That appears against the option 3. Therefore, the option 3 is true. And obviously, options 1 and 2 we are not getting here, and they are not true. They are not true. So our final answer is options 3 and 4 are true. But you may note down that the official answer key gives different set of answers. So note, this answer, what we have got, options 3 and 4 are true, differs from the official answer key. It's up to you to verify and to see whether options 1 and 2 are true or not. But according to this analysis, they are not true, and 3 and 4 are true. So that is the discussion of the solution of the problem that is on the differential equations. And it is an interesting problem, and I am sure that you have liked the proof of it, and you go on working out some more problems on these lines. I wish you all the best. Thank you.